Hey, man, you better hurry up. You better come on if you want to catch this episode of the Trucker Stable. You better hustle, hustle, hustle. You're never going to make it walking like that, man. Come on. Come on, jump up in here and let's catch this next episode of the Trucker's Table, starting right now.
Loading, we're fixing the head out. But you know me, I want to throw a couple straps on. I want to take any chance on stuff moving around back there. We already got our placards put on. Toxic, oh Lord, that's pesticide. And we got everything taped down with the placards. Pop our, there we go. We're going to slide them babies all the way up. So I think we're light enough. Yeah, oh my God. I just got done talking to one of my YouTube buddies about this. We're going to have to go back and get a bunch more straps because, I'm not riding with it like that. Well, without straps on it. We'll start at the front. We'll put a strap on every pallet and just hope and pray for the best that it don't fall over. But, yeah, we're not just going to try to ride down the road with it like that. That's ridiculous right there. If y'all been following me for a few years now, you know I had some sulfur bags like that before that fell over and pinched into the straps. Couldn't even get the straps out. So we're not going to take any chances. We're going to go ahead and get some more straps. We're going to get that strap down and I'll show you what it looks like when we get done. All right. We got us a box full of straps. So we're fixing to start strapping and see if we can't get this looking like it's supposed to. So y'all stay right there and I'll see what we can do.
I'm a hard-working man. I wear a steel hard hat. I can ride rope, a hammer and paint. Do things with my hands that most men can't. I can't get ahead no matter how hard I try. I'm getting really good at barely getting by. Got everything I own by the sweat of my brow. From my four-wheel drive to my cowboy boots, I owe it all to my blue-collar roots. Feel like I'm working overtime on a runaway train. I got to bust loose from this ball and chain. I'm a hard-working man. I got it all on the line for a piece of the promised land. And I'm burning my candle at both ends. About the only way to keep the fire going is to outrun the wind.
All we can do is hope and pray, right? Thank you, Lord. Please let it stay. Woo, we'll see. All right, but anyway, see, we got straps going down it and that one around the back. So all we can do is hope and pray for the best. Try not to drive too crazy. I'll do my best. All right, y'all hang around. Let's get out of here.
Woo! We are crossing the Newport News Channel. Is it Channel with a T or Channel? Yeah, we're crossing the old channel. We got a tunnel up ahead. And I can see the big air shaft up yonder now. And apparently we went through the wrong tunnel. We tried to go through a tunnel. Man, I want to say it was over by Chesapeake Bay, maybe somewhere over that way. Anyway, they flagged us in, pulled us in. Yeah, you can't go through here. And so they sent me back all the back way around Virginia. Bridgman to get from over there where we were at to over here on 664, wherever it is. And so he said, the good news is you can just go out here and get on and go back around. And the trooper's not going to write you a $1,000 ticket. I said, a ticket for what? He said, you didn't stop at the inspection station. I said, the sign said, stop when flashing. The sign and the lights were not flashing. Why would I stop? You know, that makes sense, right? I could take that to court and win, couldn't I? You know, I got it on dash cam. The lights were not flashing. So why should I stop? So he never said nothing else, and I went ahead and left. So I get over here and I stop back here. This inspection said the same thing. It had a sign that said stop when flashing. Well, it wasn't flashing, but I saw somebody over there, so I went ahead and stopped. And so I pulled in, you know, he wrote down my information and everything. And I said, sir, let me ask you a question. If I had not stopped, would I got in trouble? He goes, yeah, I would have called ahead of her to the tunnel and they would have flagged you down. I said, but why? He goes, I said, look at this. And I showed him a picture right here. You know, it says, stop. And he goes, oh, no, that sign is for if you are over height. If you're over height, then it'll flash and then you have to stop. I'm like, show me where it says that on here. All it says is stop when flashing. It doesn't say if over height sign will flash and then you stop or anything that has to do with being over height. I don't live in Virginia. I don't know all the rules up here. I don't even come through here but maybe once or twice a year. And very seldom am I hauling hazmat, so I just haul ass. I don't ever stop. So he goes, yeah, these signs have been around for 25 years. They confuse a lot of people. So yeah, I would have took that shit to court. I would have went in there and pulled a who is that? I don't know. Maybe a pulled of my cousin Vinny. I would have been Joe Pesci. Is it Joe Pesci? Joe Piscopo. No, Joe Pesci. Yeah, Joe Pesci. I would have been up in there, you know, and I would have argued with him till he just cried and gave up. Ain't no way I would have took that ticket. Anyway, we're going to see if we can't get through the old tunnel. Traffic is super slow. That's why I hate freaking Virginia, man. If I never come to Virginia again, it won't bother me. All right, let's hope and pray this tunnel does not collapse. See, I guess they would have pulled me in right here and checked me out. And I don't know if they would have let me go or, I mean, how can I turn around? I don't see a place to turn around. That's up here, there is. Ah, damn. Google Maps just hollered in my ear and said there's a wreck about a quarter mile ahead. So, dang it. I got a feeling we're going to be stuck in traffic. Underneath all this water and this daggum tunnel. They couldn't just build a big ass bridge. Huh? You couldn't just build a big ass bridge. Excuse me. So, anyway, there's a good chance we're going to come to a stop. Getting a full view and it's on out of the wall. That's because the mount on my dash, I can't get it to spin around any more than that. Oh, but I'm taking it apart and taking it loose. Yep, not much now. Let's hope we don't break down when we get out.
Made it out of here. Let's get going. We'll check back y'all later. All right.
What's that, duck man? What you smelling? Concrete? Let's come on down here with us some grass and trees. That duck. You gotta shake a leg, buddy. We only got about 5-10 minutes. We gotta go. Whew. Hear that jake break? Yeah, we left this morning. Maryland, and he used the bathroom up there, but then when we got down there to where we picked up at, it was hazmat. He couldn't really get out there, so we come on, dead. Come on. So we finally got out of traffic, so I figured we'd stop here along the way. Dead. Come on, ducky, come on, buddy. I don't know if I get back up that hill or not. We'll see. But I figured we'd walk that round out here real quick. I saw some stuff over here. Thought I'd check it out. Let's see what we got over here. I always like learning new stuff. Go pee pee poo poo. Go ahead. Go pee pee poo poo. All right, what does it say? Why is native habitat so important? Yeah. If you want to read, just pause it and read it. okay, so what we got? Pollinators. Yeah. Tear it up, duck. Tear it up, buddy. And we have one over here. Like to eat? Think a pollinator. How about the Terminator? Or the Intimidator? Dale Earnhardt. What, what? Did you know? There you go, huh? There's you some did you knows. Pollination services to U.S. crops is valued at $10 billion. Holy crap. I gotta buy some bees. Ooh, my mom's favorite, hummingbirds. My mom loves some hummingbirds. That's a beautiful one there. We got them around our house. We got hummingbird feeders. We got at least two, I want to say three for sure. At least two for sure, maybe three that we see all the time around our house. I guess that's natural habitat out there. I saw another guy walking around with his dog, so that's why I brought Ducky on over here. So he wouldn't run into him. I don't know where the guy went. He was over by the steps. Maybe he's done and already took him back. What are you doing, Dad? What you doing? Oh, yeah. See the wonderful smells of Virginia, Dad. Smells like a bunch of wimps. yeah, I got to climb back up that hill. I don't know if I'm going to make it. I ain't sure going to give it a try. Whew, I guess I can walk down there and take the stairs like a normal person. You feel better? A couple pounds lighter? Yeah, I wanted to make it over into Kentucky, man. But right now, I just want to get it down to where I only got 600 miles to go. Once I get down to that 600 mile mark, shut her down. I'm tired. But yeah, we'll shut her down. We got about 600 miles to go because I can drive that tomorrow, get parked and be ready to get unloaded first thing Friday morning. We still got to book us a load to pick up Friday. Had some offers today, some good loads, paying like $4.15 a mile. Some good paying freight, man. I just got to pick what I want to do. Most all that good freight paying freight is coming back to Virginia. But I did see one going to Savannah. I might take it. And there was one going to Laredo that was paying, okay. I think it was $3.15 a mile. But I don't know. I'd love to take that load to Laredo just to get back to some kind of normalness. But I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, I'm going to try to climb this hill, and I'm not going to let you see. So y'all, go get you a snack, get ready, and we'll finish up the rest later on. All right, don't go nowhere. Hang around.
See the trailer burn down, and the guy was smart enough to drop it and pull the bobtail out from under it to keep from burning down the truck as well. Smart driver.
All right, look at that. Nothing fell over. Everything's still standing up. Yeah. Whew. All right, we're going to get up in there and get our straps loose. And, I know you can't see it. There he goes, yeah. He's over there running around. The place we're delivering is right over there. The other side of those tankers right there. So hopefully they won't come out here and run us off. We'll be able to park over here and pull in there in the morning and get unloaded. And then head on down towards Jackson, Missouri for our next pickup. So we're gonna get these straps off. Woo! And then we go in, get ready for bed, maybe have some dinner. So, y'all hold on, let's get these straps off.
Well, it's easy for a country boy to be misunderstood when the honky-tonks are jumping and the girls are looking good. Yeah, I get excited and some people think I'm rude. It's the way my daddy raised me, it's my rebel attitude. I'm a Southern boy. Southern born and bred. I got sweet home Alabama buzzing all around in my head. I'm right at home in Georgia, down in Carolina. Yeah, I'd be happy anywhere below the Mason-Dixon line. Working and sweating till I hear that whistle blow. Country rocker cooking on my pickup radio. I rush home for a shower and put on my dancing shoes. I get the Friday fever and the Sunday morning blues. And I'm a Southern boy. I like a rowdy crowd. Put more seat for some of the jukebox and turn that sucker way up loud.
All right, we got everything off. Unstrapped, so all we got to do is pull in the morning, get unloaded, and get our butt out of here. So let's go. Ooh, boy, oh boy. Well, we got unloaded early, and I thought we would. So now we're fixing to book it down to Jackson, Missouri, and pick up our getting home load. Oh yeah, look at that. They didn't even make a mess. Let's go and get that out of there. Ducky's over there running around. I'm letting him take care of his business. I had to hide him in the back. That. Come on. Go pee pee poop poop. There you go. Go pee pee poop poop. He likes to stay where I'm at, see? So I had to walk with him and coax him to go use the bathroom because he didn't want to leave me. He's afraid I'm going to leave him, I guess. I ain't never left him before. Anyway, I got to get a haircut. Can you tell? Whew. Already got our coffee made. Breakfast is heating up in the microwave now. Whew. As soon as he's done, we're gonna hit the road. Agent's already blowing up my phone. You gonna be there by 9:30? I'm like, didn't we have this conversation? When I booked the load, I told you I'm delivering in St. Louis at 8 o'clock. And it'd probably be closer to 10:30 at the earliest before I can get down there. She playing dumb, like, oh, I don't remember that. The hell you don't. Anyway, oh boy done lightened his load a little bit there, so we're gonna jump in the truck and see if we can't get going. Y'all come on and find out what's going on at Proctor and Gamble.
Yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. There he is, duck man. So you gotta drain the main vein there. he got him a little grass that run around. Uh-oh, he's chasing something. Maybe he'll come back. Oh, shit. What the hell is that? Is that a possum? What the hell is that? What the hell is that? Is that a possum? Looks like a possum, don't it? Damn, boy. Good thing McGee ain't here to be a dead possum. Don't you mess with that possum, boy. I guess that's what that is. Dang. Lord have mercy. Yeah, we are just south of Montgomery, Alabama. Whew. We could have made it on down to Troy, but I stopped to get fuel in Montgomery. Ducky, get away from that. Get back over here in the grass. Ducky, get back over here in the grass. Get away from all that junk. I swear, Ducky, why the hell would you be going out into the damn pavement and you got all this grass back here? I swear, you're the hard-headedest boy I've ever seen. Have you ever seen a dog that's got all this freaking grass to run around and play in, maybe some possums to chase down, and he wants to run out into the daggum middle of the damn parking lot? What's the matter? You done lost your mind? You done going insane? Go chase that possum. Have some fun. Yeah, go chase that opossum. McGee would chase it. Look at it. He's over there sniffing around all that junk. I ain't never seen nothing like it. Watch it. Look at him. He's gonna turn and walk right out to all that pavement. Look at him. Have you ever seen anything like that? I ain't never seen nothing like that. All this grass and he's over there walking around the pavement. You ain't gonna do nothing, we're gonna go get back in the truck. So I think you done lost your mind. Whew. I swear, I ain't never seen him act this crazy before. It's like he don't know what the hell he wants to do. All right, well, we're about 3 hours from the house. And, so we'll be home before lunch tomorrow. And I don't know for sure yet. I'm thinking about maybe just doing an 8-hour break and then driving on down there because we're delivering to a Sam's Club. So we get down there. We can park in their parking lot overnight. Appointment's at 9:30 a.m. Sunday morning. So if we get down there around 1 a.m., you know, we could do another 8-hour break or whatever. Have plenty of time to make it back to the house. So we may do that. I'm not sure yet. Have to wait and see. But yeah, I'd rather go down there late at night like that. Traffic won't be so bad. Get on in there, find a place to park, and get unloaded and come on back to the house. Because we got a lot of stuff we got to get done around the house Monday and Tuesday. So that's probably what we'll do. Anyway, we'll catch up with y'all later. I'm on Roundup, Looney Tooney over here, and see if we can't get back in the truck, have some dinner, and go to bed. All right, we'll talk to y'all later. Well, we're going to go ahead and end the video here. We, like I said, we're south of Montgomery, headed down to Tampa. We got a delivery down there to Sam's Club, and then we're going to deadhead back to the house, do some things around the house. Then we're picking up a load in Troy, Alabama, taking that to Manassas. So we'll pick it back up somewhere along in there. But in the meantime, thank y'all so much for coming along with us on this journey. Woo, where are we been? We was up in, I think it was in Virginia. And then we went over to, we picked up there in Virginia. Then we went over to St. Louis. And then we picked up there in Missouri, back down to Tampa. Yeah, we've been pretty busy. But anyway, thank y'all for coming along with us. We appreciate it. And thank you so much for liking, subscribing, and ringing the little bell icon so you'll be notified every time we upload a video. Where'd that little stinker butt go? He was just around here somewhere. Anyway, he's taking care of business, and we're going to get back in the truck and get a little rest. Woo, see if we can't make it down to Havana tomorrow. But in the meantime, y'all stay safe, and we'll catch you on the next vlog. All right. And even when it's bad weather outside, Ducky's over chasing possums. He ain't gonna give up. Nah. He catches that possum, he's gonna keep punching.